Howdy friends, we've missed 4 days of Vlogmas. 4 days? I think. What's the last one? Last day of Vlogmas was... Vlogmas day 7, and it is day 13. So we've missed 5. I'm doing really good today. I'm doing really good this year. I ended up spending the weekend with Matt and my family, and just didn't have a lot to vlog. So I didn't. Not that I have much to vlog now anyway, but I'm going to start my gym regime this evening and figured I'd take you guys with me. And, you know, tonight's a work night for me anyway, but... I'm doing some random things around. Hopefully, excuse me, I won't be alone all night again tonight, but it's looking like that's probably what it's gonna be. So I've got some stuff to do, and, yeah, maybe it'll take you along in the process, maybe not. I got some floors to clean tonight, so I gotta clean my, change my boots. I gotta finish hanging up some signs, which I can't show you because it has the signage from, or like the emblem logo. Good God. It has the logo of the place I work on it. So, yeah, this will be a grand old time. I'm basically a glorified janitor, so that's the super fun part. I do a lot of things, but it's mostly cleaning. But I have to finish hanging up some signs for our master sanitation schedules. And yeah, so I just wanted to start the vlog. Oh, by the way, vlog was day 13. Fantastic. Welcome to Vlogmas Day 13. Ta-da! I'm so tired. I need to get into a better routine, like with my life in general. Like, I need to set a time that I actually wake up every day, because I feel like this, I either sleep too much or I don't sleep enough. And I've got other things that I gotta do, and blah, 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 blah. Yeah, not a great time. I'm really fucking things up for myself. But I'm trying to fix that. Or I want to try to fix that. So I'm gonna go finish hanging my signs. Get prepped to clean some floors. Shouldn't be too bad tonight. Nobody gave me anything specific to do, so we're just gonna go on. I have my laptop over here, that's why I'm leaning this way. What's up? Okay. I'm taking my personal training course and my CPR certification, is dead. That's the word I'm using. Expired. It expired. my CPR expired and I need it for that. For the course. So I'm gonna do it through them. I wasn't yawning until I started filming this. Anyway, I'm gonna go finish hanging my signs. And then I'll clean the floor. My camera's crooked. You're just gonna have to deal with it. So, we're back. I did my things. I took a little break and did some studying. Not much of studying. I just went through a couple of the sections in my chapter. Went out, deep cleaned the floor like I said I was going to. I only did like 3 panels of the floor. I'll make my way around through the week. They're canning tomorrow, so I'm going to clean the floor around there tomorrow. And no one told me if we are running tomorrow. It looks like we are at 7. So I have to go fill our pasteurizer tunnel because I'm not sure if I'm supposed to do it, but it says 7 a.m. start time, and Jordan gets here at 5, and it takes like 2 hours from empty to fill. So I'm going to fill it. I'm going to go fill that, make sure the boiler is all set. So at least production has it tomorrow. It says it's only a 2-hour runtime, but they're also changing over. They have 1 million people during the day. So I'd imagine the changeover will be fine, but I don't know. I don't know. But yeah, it's a 7K run and I'm gonna go start filling the pasteurizer. I'll see you in what's a second for you, but in millennial for me. Millennia. Okay, so I'm going out to let my truck run for a little while before I leave. I've got like 20 minutes, which sounds like a long time to let it run, but it's been sitting for 8 hours in the cold. It's absolutely freezing outside. So I'm gonna go do that and prepare to leave. I don't have much else to do. I had to bring the tape gun back because it's not for the canning line, it was for packaging. And I stole it. A thief. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe we'll talk a little bit when I get in the truck. But my hair is really dirty. I need to take a shower. I showered when I got home last night, but I didn't wash my hair. And I am reaping the benefits of that. I'm gonna go start the truck and put away my shit. This vlog is riveting.
Hello!
Welcome to Vlogmas Day 14. Kind of. It's currently 2:18 on the 15th. we're doing real good with this Vlogmas right now. obviously, I skipped some days on accident. I'm having a really hard time with like my mental health and such lately. It's just been real rough. I wanted to say something now, but I will hook you guys up in the truck and we'll talk in the truck on the way home about our mental health. Sounds like a staple of my channel. Anyway, I'm gonna pack up and go home. Hello. I had to swap sweatshirts because I had my company sweatshirt on. That was not cute. Anyway, hi. We're back. We're here. I'm going home. might not be able to see me too great, but we'll try. Hopefully. I haven't been here in the winter yet, so this has been an interesting thing that's going on. I have to close the gate. I was gonna go to the gym tonight, but I forgot my socks.
Which sounds like an excuse, and it completely is just an excuse. But I have a really hard time with textures, and one of the textures is the inside of shoes without socks. I actually genuinely hate it. So I'm going to repack my bag. There's a nice little light going on because you can't see me. Let me do this. You can tell I'm a really good YouTuber. Expert vlogger. I'm gonna pull up my GPS. And maybe that'll give me some. Maybe it'll give me some light. A little bit. Not really. Sorry, I still got like a full battery. Did that close all the way? Yes, it did. I am so tired. But yeah, I have a texture thing, and it's not fun to deal with. But I also need to plan out what I want to do. I know I want to kick off with a leg day. Get it? Kick off leg day. I'm hilarious. I want to kick off with a leg day. So I want to plan that, and I want to start getting more targeted with my workouts. Because I have to learn, because I'm taking my personal training certification, which I think I said in a clip from yesterday. I want to be more targeted and not just go in the gym and kind of do what I want. I want to, like, genuinely try. My main goal right now is losing weight. And feeling, honestly, mostly just feeling better, but I do want to lose some weight. I have gained quite a bit of weight over the last couple months. It's basically, like, relationship weight, unfortunately for me. But the sign of a healthy relationship. Yeah, like I said, more targeted, more, like, I want to be better with it, and it'll be great, but I need to plan out what I actually want to do. So I'm also going to try to actually get myself into a routine, like a normal people routine, because I work at night, I sleep most of the day, which is unfortunate for me, because I miss out on a lot of things. I was supposed to get up early and help somebody bring something to the dump, and I completely slept through it until about an hour before I had to leave for work, and the dump was closed. So I want to get on a better schedule, and I feel like that'll help me with everything else going on. But I think I may have said in an earlier clip that I'm having some serious issues with my mental health right now, and it has not been fun at all. I don't really know what it is. I'm not usually a person that gets seasonal depression. I actually get it, I get seasonal depression, but it's the opposite of what normal people get. So normal people get it in the winter. I get it in the summer because I hate the summer. It is my least favorite season ever. And I know I sound like a pick-me girl when I say it like that, but I hate summer. It's not fun for me. I like going to the beach, it's fun, but I do not like 110 degree days or 100 degree days, whatever. I hate the heat. It is my least favorite. I'm not a big fan of winter either, but I prefer it over the summer. But I think because I got out of a depressive episode a few weeks ago, and I'm still kind of teetering in and out of it, so I think that might be part of it. I have no idea. There's like 80 different factors that it could be, and it's really annoying. So I'm trying to figure out what my problem is and how I can fix it, I guess, or at least make it easier on myself, make life easier on myself. I feel like I've shut down a little bit with people, and I'm not trying to do that, but I have definitely shut down and not talked to people for the last couple of weeks. And if I have talked to people, it's rare. I haven't really gone out. Not that I really have been anyway, because I'm trying to save to move. Oh yeah. Probably shouldn't quite say that yet. I've just been trying to save, and going out was, like, especially, like, to bars and stuff was my kryptonite over the summer, because went through a breakup, and then we got back together, and the breakup really hit me hard. So I was hanging with my friends a lot, we were going out to bars a lot, and I was trying to not let it get to me, but them being in relationships really, like, got me, like, sucker punched me. So I kind of stopped hanging out with my friends, because I didn't want to be, I love their girlfriends, I do, they are also my friends, but I couldn't stomach hanging around couples anymore. It was really sad. I felt really bad. And I have not been quiet about what has been triggering me. Like, when I finally figured out that that's what was bothering me, I did tell them. I wasn't keeping it from them. I did tell them. And they didn't blame me. They weren't mean about it. Like, they understood, because they've been there, but, like, that kind of makes me feel like a shitty friend, you know? Even though it's not me being a shitty friend, it's just me being depressed. But I'm trying to get better now, trying to figure out what I need to do to make myself feel better. And right now, I have no idea what that is. Absolutely none. I wish I knew. And it has not been... It has not been easy. But this past weekend, I just took some time and didn't do much. I got my sis... My sisters and I do this not-so-secret Santa where we pick each other because there's so many of us. I have three younger sisters. And then my parents, and then, you know, significant others and all that, but we used to get gifts for each other every year, so that's three people already, plus my parents, so that's five, and then, like, our friends and whatever, so we, as we got older, we decided to do a not-so-secret Santa, so we would pick a sister, and, like, randomly pick a sister, and that's who we got Christmas gifts for. This year, they included Aaron, Alicia's boyfriend, and Matt, my boyfriend. So, I was helping Matt pick out something for Alicia, and I got my sister Emily some stuff. And I don't think she watches these, but I'm not going to take the chance, and I'm not going to show you. But I got her. I had to call her. I called her the day before, and I was like, okay, I know what I'm going to get you. But I want to make sure, because she asked for romance books. I'm not going to tell you which ones I got, but I asked her, what type of romance do you like? Because there's a very big spectrum, and you either get cheesy romance, like Nora Roberts. Roberts? No. Is that who it is? I don't know. Like cheesy Fabio on the cover, or... smut. like Katie Roberts Disney retelling, not safe for children. And she said somewhere in between, but closer to cheesy. So I'm like, okay, I think I can do that. Because I have a friend who's wicked on the other side of the spectrum. So I just wanted to make, I didn't want to get her something she wasn't going to read, because what's the point in that? So I got her hopefully something that she hopefully will like. I hope she does. I'll honestly be kind of sad if she doesn't like it. But, and then Matt got my other sister something, and we picked it out together, and he was just like, okay. And my mother continuously called me that day because they were out shopping. I had stayed at Matt's house the night before, and she called me, and she's like, she was in the area that I live, and she was like, I know you'd be mad if I didn't tell you. I was like, well, I'm not even there. So, but they ended up being there when I went home, so I ended up hanging out with them for a little bit anyway, and then I got my friend Charlie something, and Ashley, so now I kind of, like, I already figured I was going to make, I'm going to make things for my other friends, but the other two things, my friend Charlie is, I got her something specific, and it was something that I was planning on, so I got her something specific, but, and Ashley said something, and it was cheap enough, and I was like, okay, well, I'll get you a Christmas present, because we were originally not going to get each other anything. We lived together, and we both said that the rent is enough for Christmas. So, but I did end up getting her something. I told her she didn't have to give me anything. I tried to give it to her, and she's like, no, if it's a Christmas present, I'm not taking it now. I'm like, okay. That's fine, I guess. So, I'm almost done. Almost. That's a cop. But it's been fun. Terrifying. Why does this happen to me? Oh my god.
I forgot to end the vlog again. I'm doing very good at this. I'm a very good YouTuber. Thanks so much for watching. Follow me on all the things. I love you. See you in the next one. Goodbye. Doesn't matter if the snow is falling, or the windows and the rain is pouring, it will always be Christmas in my